Thank you. a spell pass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
On behalf of Bishop Terry, my fellow Jubilarians, Monsignor Dacey, Canon Grant, and Father John Bain, and our other priests and Deacon Pat here, the warmest of welcomes to one and all. So good evening, Teesside, and thank you for turning out for our celebration of Jubilees. Some people are joining us on live stream, so we welcome those who are joining us on the live stream. Wherever you are, welcome to you. My mother, who was called Grace, when she was a young child, and she lived on a family farm, and every day she journeyed down from her hillside on their hillside farm to the local well. And there she met her neighbors as they filled up their churns of water. That's where she caught up on the news, who was courting, who was poorly, who had died. And then after some time chatting, she'd go back home with her churns full of water for the farm animals. I mentioned that because Pope Francis fairly recently, he compared our Eucharist and indeed compared the church to the village well, where we come who are thirsty, where we come to be refreshed and nourished, and where we are mandated and commissioned to go back out and to continue our mission. Speaking of wells and water, Today the church celebrates the feast of St. John the Baptist, the birth of John the Baptist. He is the only saint that has two feast days in the liturgical calendar. His birth, and on the 29th of August we celebrate his martyrdom. So he's a very important saint in the church. And he too was a great missioner. And he too used lots of water as he baptized and called people to discipleship. So we come now to the fountain of all holiness. We come to be refreshed. We bring our thirsts and our needs. We thank God for his blessings to us down the years. And we thank God and praise God for all his goodness for those whom we love and cherish. So as we pause for a moment, let's gather our intentions, who we want to and what we want to pray for, as we pause in silence. So once again, let's repair our relationship with God by recognizing our shortcomings from your booklet, Penitential Act. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Excelsis Deo.
Thank you.
Hieronymus. Holy Father, who by no merit of our own chose us for communion with the eternal priesthood of your Christ and for the ministry of your church, grant that we may be an ardent yet gentle preacher of the gospel and a faithful steward of your mysteries. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. Islands, listen to me. Pay attention, remotest peoples. The Lord called me before I was born. From my mother's womb, he pronounced my name. He made my mouth a sharp sword and hid me in the shadow of his hand. He made me into a sharpened arrow and concealed me in his quiver. He said to me, "You are my servant Israel, in whom I shall be glorified." While I was thinking, "I have toiled in vain, I have exhausted myself for nothing," and all the while, my cause was with the Lord, my reward with my God. I was honored in the eyes of the Lord. My God was my strength. And now, the Lord has spoken. He who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, to gather Israel to him. It is not enough for you to be my servant, to restore the tribes of Jacob and bring back the survivors of Israel. I will make you the light of the nations, so that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The wonder of my being.
Thank you, Lord, for the one.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul said, God made David the king of our ancestors, of whom he approved in these words, I have elected David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart, who will carry out my whole purpose to keep his promise. God has raised up from Israel one of David's descendants, Jesus, a Savior, whose coming was heralded by John when he proclaimed a baptism of repentance for the whole people of Israel. Before John ended his career, he said, I am not the one you imagine me to be. That one is coming after me, and I am not fit to undo his sandal. My brothers, sons of Abraham's race, and all you who fear God, this message of salvation is meant for you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be on your heart and on your lips. I warmly announce his holy gospel, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The time came for Elizabeth to have her child, and she gave birth to a son, and whom her neighbors and relations heard that the Lord had shown her so great a kindness, they shared her joy. Now on the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child. They were going to call him Zechariah, after his father. But his mother spoke up. No, she said, he is to be called John. Then he said to her, but no one in your family has that name, and made the sign to his father to find out what he wanted him called. The father asked for a writing table and wrote, the name is John. And they were so astonished at what instant his power of speech returned, and he spoke and praised God. All their neighbors were filled with awe, and the whole affair was thrown about throughout the hill country of Judea. All that heard of it treasured it in their hearts. What will this child come out to be? They wondered. And indeed, the hand of the Lord was with him. The child grew up, and his spirit matured, and he lived out in the wilderness until the day he appeared openly in Israel. This is the gospel of the Lord.
I didn't really know what Mass I was going to be preaching at this evening, because the liturgy is a little bit confused at this time. We did the World Meeting of Families last night, and I was disappointed that I couldn't do St. John Fisher and St. Thomas More. But then I found I shouldn't have been doing it anyway, because John the Baptist had been moved, because the Sacred Heart has taken his place. So I had no idea which particular readings I was going to be preaching on this evening. But it's good to be kept guessing. I'm very grateful to my fellow priests, the Jubilarians, for asking me to preach. It's not for any particular gift of preaching, but simply because I'm the vocations director. They thought, if anybody can talk about priesthood, perhaps he can. Boy, were they wrong. And I was thinking about our four Jubilarians, about Monsignor Dacey and Canon Grant, Canon Gubbins and Father Bain, and imagine them in civvies in a bar. It's not very hard, to be honest. But when you see them together, you think, what on earth do they have in common? Different ages, different interests, different way of being. And yet, there is something which is very basically in common, very fundamentally in common. They responded to a call of God. God spoke, I want you to be a priest. And I don't know all of their individual vocation stories, because every vocation is unique and different. But every vocation is beautiful. And every vocation is astonishing. And sometimes, when I look at our priests, I can't help but be astonished. But I was thinking mainly about John the Baptist. When he went in to the people of Israel after his years in the desert, he didn't preach himself. He didn't say, look at me, although people did look at him, because, let's be honest, he wasn't dressed very conventionally. But he said, this isn't about me. There is one coming after me who is much greater than I am, and I'm not fit to undo his sandals. The priests, our Jubilarians this evening, are the same. I wonder, perhaps, if priests are more like John the Baptist than they are the apostles. Because the apostles knew Christ intimately. They went around Israel with him. They spoke to him. John didn't really speak directly to him very much. But still, he loved him. He loved Jesus above all things. And he said, it is essential that I decrease and he increases. And that is the mission of a priest. That we should diminish, that we should no longer be seen, but rather that we should promote Christ. Christ should be visible in our lives. Christ should be visible in our welcome. Christ should be visible in the things that we say, the things that we do, and indeed in just the way that we are. Because if we can be Christ to the world, if we can witness to Christ, then the church will continue to grow. We have this evening four faithful priests to celebrate. We celebrate their gift of vocation, but we celebrate too their gift of generosity. Because vocation without an answer is simply a call in the wild. It isn't a vocation truly until it is answered. And by living out that vocation, our priests say to the world, Christ still matters. Jesus is still important. His people still need the Eucharist. His people still need forgiveness. And so we are here. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. We hear that hymn sung so often at Mass, perhaps to the point where we feel that it's overplayed. But nevertheless, it sums up who we are as priests. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. And God hasn't stopped calling. God still seeks people to respond to his call. But we need that same spirit of generosity, that same spirit of reaction and answering the Lord. And so it's essential, because I don't want to be rude to my fellow priests, but they're not getting any younger. I am. And you can see, just looking around, there aren't many young ones. We're blessed. We have two recent vocations. Just recently, had a number of young men ring me up about the priesthood, which is gratifying, because for 2 years I've heard nothing. God is still calling. God is still asking. His people are still listening. So let us tonight ask for the intercession of John the Baptist, that others will come forward to bear witness to his beloved Christ. Let us pray too for our jubilarians, that they may continue to be blessed, continue to be faithful, and continue to bring Christ to his people.
Invite you to stand for the prayers of the faithful. Oh yes, thank you. I have miscued slightly. We, on this solemn occasion, have the creed on your booklets. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of God. Amen. We now bring our prayers to God our Father.
For all priests who are ordained to serve our church, that their ministry may be fruitful and appreciated by the people whom they serve.
Lord, in your mercy.
For the gift to our diocese of vocations to the ordained priesthood, that good men may be drawn to love and to serve the people of God.
Lord, in your mercy.
For retired priests, that they may experience God's abundant love as they walk a new path of prayer and servanthood in retirement.
Lord, in your mercy.
For our priests celebrating Jubilees this year, that we may affirm, support, and celebrate their gifts of service to us.
Lord, in your mercy.
That we may never take the presence of our priests for granted, as we cherish the celebration of the Mass and are nourished by the Eucharist.
Lord, in your mercy.
For all priests who struggle with loneliness, declining health, or loss of mobility, that they may be comforted by the grace of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, in your mercy.
For priests who now sleep in peace of the resurrection, that God lead them gently into their eternal reward.
Especially here, I'd like us to remember Father Ted Scales and Father Patrick Cope. In 1982, five of us were ordained for the diocese. So we remember Father Ted Scales and Father Patrick Cope. That God will lead them, that God has led them gently to their eternal reward. Lord, in your mercy.
We ask Our Lady to intercede for all our prayers. Hail.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen. Father, we ask you to hear all our prayers and to keep us in your tender, loving care. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. If you help to set up the altar. Pray, brothers and sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. We place these offerings on your altar, O Lord, to celebrate with fitting honor the nativity of him who both foretold the coming of the world's Savior and pointed him out when he came, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Continuing to unite with those on live stream, the Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always, and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In his precursor, St. John the Baptist, we praise your great glory, for you consecrated him for a singular honor among those born of women. His birth brought great rejoicing. Even in the womb he leapt for joy at the coming of human salvation. He alone of all the prophets pointed out the Lamb of Redemption. And to make holy the flowing waters, he baptized the very author of baptism and was privileged to bear him supreme witness by the shedding of his blood. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Eucharistic prayer number 3. You are holy, you are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate a memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint John the Baptist, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely from failing help.
And may this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Pope Francis and our Bishop Terence Patrick, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, especially Father Ted Scales, Father Patrick Cope, the recent deceased Deacon Philip Black, and all past clergy of the diocese, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord, the risen Lord, be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. That was your line, Pat. I greet you, brothers. Peace be with you. Peace, brother. Peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
To invite you now for Holy Communion, or if for any reason or circumstance you're not receiving the sacrament, to encourage you to come for a blessing. Mm-hmm. 5. Body of Christ. 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 Christ, body of Christ, blessing of Christ. Ah, lovely, congratulations. Blessing of Christ, amen. Body of Christ, the body of Christ, the body of Christ, body of Christ. The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ, amen. Body of Christ, Paul, amen. Body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ, Brian. Body of Christ, 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 body of Christ. 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 Christ. Body of 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 Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ.
Thank you.
Let us stand.
Let us pray. For the glory of your name, O Lord, for the glory of your name, we have joyfully celebrated the mystery of faith to mark the anniversary of our priestly ordinations, so that we may be in truth what we have handled mystically in this sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated as I ask our Chief Shepherd, Bishop Terry, to speak to us.
So, between the Jubilarians, if I've got my maths right, 3 rubies, 1 silver, that's 145 years of priestly ministry, priestly service. Certainly something to stop and to celebrate this evening and to thank Almighty God for. So they bring with them all sorts of gifts from County Limerick, from Birmingham, from Hull, from Middlesbrough, trained in different colleges, St. Patrick's Thurles, All Hallows, Dublin, St. Joseph's up Holland, St. Cuthbert's at Ushaw. All very different characters, as Canon Allen said earlier on, from all sorts of backgrounds, but strong and loyal members of the Presbyterate of Middlesbrough Diocese. Thinking about them and thinking what I might say at Mass this evening, I couldn't stop my mind turning to a literary reference. 4 of them, one younger than the others. So yes, my thoughts went to D'Artagnan and the 3 Musketeers. So let me quote from a summary of the characters who appear in this famous novel by Alexandre Dumas. D'Artagnan, the hero, a young man raised in the French province of Gascony, who leaves home to go to Paris. Brave, excellent swordsman, and enthusiastic to become a musketeer, but also impulsive, hot-headed, and inexperienced. Athos, leader of the 3 Musketeers, full of shadows, intelligent, courageous, precise in his sword fighting. Porthos, humorous, vain, slave to fashion, good-hearted, comical and jaunty in his sword fighting. Aramis, romantic, handsome, hot-tempered, studying to be a priest, melodramatic in his sword fighting. Well, I'm not going to say who's who, but I'm sure as I was reading those things out, you could put 2 and 2 together and make 4. As the years have gone by, I'm sure that the musketeer's motto will have proved just as descriptive of our Jubilarians, that is of Monsignor Canon Gerard Daisy, Canon Provost David Grant, Canon Edmund Govins, and Father John Bain. Unus pro omnibus, omnes pro uno, one for all and all for one. May the Lord prosper you all and grant you many, many, many more years and many, many more blessings. Ad multos annos and congratulations.
We stand now for the concluding rite of blessing and final hymn. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Before we go in the peace of Christ, there's some hospitality at the back there, I notice, so a chance to linger and to meet and chat about old times. Thank you on behalf of our priests and jubilarians. Great to see so many familiar faces, and some people have also travelled up from Scarborough, so thank you for making the journey, and elsewhere in the diocese, if you've made the journey, thank you. So now let us go in peace to continue to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks.